Hello, bearded bee people. Welcome back to B&K Bees. I'm almost done with this yard, and I thought a neat video idea would be to check and see how the ground hives did. We have some hives go into winter laying on the ground every single year. Every single spring, I say I'm not going to do it like that again, and then it just sort of happens that way. So I've got these three on the ground. I'm about ready to get into this one. I'm not going to dig in too deeply, but I thought it would be interesting just to see what the cluster size looks like and see how those bees did in comparison to the ones that were up on pallets. Well, first look, looks okay, about average. I guess I wish they were filling out the left side of the box a little bit more, but it looks like they're occupying the center seven frames or so. Let's see if they're down below, and if so, what that looks like. So I usually have critters that mess with hives that are on the ground, and that could be true here too. Nice and heavy, and it looks about average. Like I said, you know, they're occupying the seven center frames up top, and maybe the five center frames down below. I'd say maybe that's slightly under average for the doubles. You know, the doubles maybe on the pallets are slightly filling out the boxes a little bit more, but definitely, I mean, not to the point where I'm like, well, this can never happen again. Obviously, it's not an ideal situation. Like I said, critters move in, and sometimes that can be an issue. But generally, healthy bees survive. And, you know, I know a lot of us worry so much about all of the minutia, the tiny, tiny little things like, you know, insulation up on top and having a quilt board for moisture and sugar bricks for excess food and all that stuff. And there's nothing wrong with any of that. But my point on this channel is often healthy bees survive. And by healthy, I mean low disease and low mite loads. You know, if you guys take care of that and monitor mites the way I preach on this channel, you'll stop blaming moisture and you'll stop blaming it being on the ground, or you'll stop blaming, you know, starvation deaths and all that kind of stuff, because stuff just generally doesn't happen that poorly when the bees are healthy, even on the starvation deaths. And obviously you're talking about a completely different cause of death, but what diminished that colony enough to where they didn't have the ability to defend and then it got robbed? Like, you know, because that's the majority of the light hive deaths that I feel in the spring are rob outs rather than actual starvation. And when I generally think that that's the case, I gravitate toward there having been some issue that diminished that colony's strength and ability to defend. So like I said, you know, healthy bees, well populated in the appropriate sized boxes, just do well and survive. I mean, even in less than ideal situations, like sitting directly on the ground throughout an entire winter in Michigan. I've got two other ground hives. Let's check them out real quick. This one looks good. Definitely had a critter in it, as you can see right there, which is once again why this is not an ideal situation. Definitely more likely to have mice and skunks mess with the hives. Nice and heavy. another similar situation. 8 frames up top, 5 or so down below. Definite signs of a mouse, but no current mouse. Spotted box has any brood in it, but I'm still not reversing. I'll do that in a couple weeks if necessary. I don't want to risk it. I don't want to dig into it. When I say I don't want to risk it, I don't want to risk chilled brood. If I brought that bottom box up top and it did have a little patch of brood in it, there'd be a big space right here where there were no bees and no brood. So a little tiny patch of brood up top, and that's a good way to get chilled brood. So I'm not going to do that. Okay, uno más. Once again, obvious signs of a critter. Let's see what they look like. Okay, that did not go great. I don't know if these guys have a queen, to be honest with you guys. Looks a little loose in here. Nope, I see eggs. Yeah, there's all types of brood. All types of open brood, anyway. Yeah, it looks good. Eggs in every cell. It's light. I'm gonna give them food. Apologize to them for shaking them around the way I have been. My back. Thank you. Okay. As I had said, it's not an ideal situation. I do honestly think that that single is a little bit diminished and, you know, lower in weight and lower in population than these ones, because of the disadvantage and the mouse and just the moisture and all that kind of stuff. So, as I said, I never plan on doing it like that. In this particular case, that hive was set there last year because a yard that we had maybe 10 miles north of here had a bear issue, and we had to move them out fast, and there were no other spots that I had. And out here, you know, just placed, what, 3 next to some pallets because we had 3 left in the truck and no pallet space. So that's how they got there. They will, of course, be moved to another yard on a pallet at some point in this year, but undoubtedly some other thing will happen, and I'll end up going through winter next winter with a few on the ground probably still. But either way, like I had said, and my whole point about this video is that healthy bees survive even in the worst conditions. Like I said, a single on the ground throughout an entire winter in Michigan with a mouse problem. And now it's April and they've got a brood nest and, what, 5 frames of bees, something like that. So, looks good. I mean, I'm happy. It could be worse anyway. I'm definitely happy with the way the bees look. We're going to have a good year if this is an omen or, you know, a sign of things to come. But thanks for watching. Get out there and have some fun with your bees. We'll have a bunch more videos the rest of this week. So pay attention for those. See ya.